Paralyzed by fear. You hear that expression, but what does it mean? We feel overpowered often by feelings of stress, worry, and anxiety. These feelings can interfere with our daily living. In some cases, fear can stop us in our tracks, affecting our job, relationships, and goals. Seattle psychologist Dr. Kate Lund joins me now. Hello, Dr. Kate. Thanks for being here.
Hello, Amity. Thank you for having me. I appreciate it.
No, this is a great topic because I don't think people understand how much fear can play a factor in our lives. But first, how does fear paralysis manifest?
Gotcha. Yeah. And you mentioned quite a few ways right as you were introducing the topic. But, you know, fear paralysis can leave us feeling stuck. It can leave us feeling powerless. It can leave us in a cycle of negative self-talk. For example, you know, having that thought over and over, I'm no good, so why even try anyway? Mm-hmm. Procrastination is often a big piece of it as well.
Yeah, that makes sense, and I've felt that way in my life. It can really impact our lives, though, in so many mm-hmm. ways. First of all, it stops us from reaching goals.
Absolutely, absolutely, because when we're paralyzed by fear, we're less likely to, you know, move towards our goals. We're likely to feel stagnant and, you know, kind of have that idea in our mind of, well, I'm not going to get to the goal anyway, so why even try? And it's often that underlying fear of failure that keeps us stuck in that place.
And it keeps us from moving towards potential, right?
Absolutely, because when we're not moving towards our goals, we're not making progress in our life. And when we're not making progress in our life, we're stuck, we're stagnant, and we're not going to kind of get to that place that we're truly capable of getting to.
And it would make sense that this would also affect relationships, all kinds of relationships.
Absolutely, because actually when we're feeling sort of paralyzed by our fears, we're probably not going to take that step forward into a relationship that could be in our best interest, or we're probably not going to step out of a relationship that's not in our best interest. So again, it's another space where we're just stuck and we're not going to kind of move towards what's going to help to enhance our overall sense of well-being mm-hmm. within the context of relationship.
Yeah, because that's a great experience. When it comes to not just reaching your goals, but it can also damage your work life, right?
Absolutely, because when we're paralyzed by fear, we're probably not going to take those calculated or, you know, appropriate risks within the context of our work lives, right? We might be sort of stuck and feeling afraid of how others are going to judge us in mm-hmm. the workplace, so we're not going to speak up.
How about, does it impact our fear of getting sick?
Well, actually, a fear of getting sick can actually be a really common manifestation of fear paralysis because, you know, we're afraid that sort of the worst case scenario is going to occur when we're paralyzed by our fears. And for many people, that sort of manifests in the form of, uh-oh, I'm going to get sick. I'm going to wake up tomorrow morning with the stomach flu. And often a specific phobia can arise out of that. For example, a fear of throwing up out of the blue. And that can really paralyze folks and shut them down.
Mine was fear of passing out, losing consciousness.
Yeah.
And it did paralyze me. It did. So what are some solutions to moving beyond these fears?
Well, you know, the first thing we want to help folks do is to manage their stress response.
Okay.
Because when our stress response isn't fully managed, fears just take over and we can't break that cycle.
What about getting the right support?
Absolutely, that's huge. So we really want to see folks getting support in the form of therapy or coaching. And you know, it's important to mention that there's not a one size fits all here, right? So that's why therapy or coaching on an individual level to come up with a roadmap for what works for you within your individual context is so vital.
And it's also, I think, for me, it took me a while to become aware that I had this intense fear. How do we get that awareness when we're kind of in the middle of it?
Right. And well, we can get that awareness really through therapy or coaching.
Okay.
And we really want to kind of, you know, dig down because the fears aren't always, as you mentioned, obvious. So therapy and coaching, talking through what's happening in our day-to-day can really help us make those connections and understand what's going on.
I know that a lot of work I've done with my therapist is this reframing the ideas that you have. That has been incredibly helpful to me. Can you explain reframing to us?
Absolutely. So once we kind of understand our fears and can kind of put a framework around them on a level that fits our individual context, we can start to look at things differently. We can start to kind of untangle the connections that are so strongly entrenched in our lives, and we can start to look at things differently. And that really, really helps to break the cycle of fear.
Dr. Kate, thank you so much for taking the time to talk to us about this, walk us through it, hopefully talk to you again.
Thank you so much. Really appreciate it.